Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Friday, February 25th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are up sharply, S&P futures up about 9 points, so we are looking for a very positive open at 9:30 Friday morning. Unfortunately, crude oil and gold are lower in the pre-market on Friday, and that could put pressure on the Canadian market. Now, today's a very abbreviated presentation containing charts from both sides of the border. Starting off with a couple of charts I'm watching closely, crude oil looks like we're topping up here at 100 bucks and could come down sharply over the next few days. Silver, we mentioned the other day, it looked like silver had topped, and then since that time, we've had one inside day after another. And so what we're looking for is a breakout above Tuesday's high, this week's high, or a breakdown below Tuesday's low, which is this week's low. And that should tell us which way this market is headed next. Big downward pressure on precious metal stocks yesterday, as Newmont reported, and apparently disappointed. Now let's take a very quick look at the U.S. markets. Not a lot of new news to talk about this morning. It was an inside day for the VIX yesterday. The VIX is up at the top of the range, still challenging those highs from late November. And what we're looking for here is a new early warning signal up at the top of the screen to tell us that this move to the upside for the VIX is over, and potential reversal to the downside, which would be supportive for higher stock prices. S&P 500 broke through 1300, but for a very short period of time yesterday, quickly reversed. That gave us a bullish reversal signal on the intraday charts. So we're still using 1300 as our line in the sand. A daily close below that would lead us to lower prices here. The inside day yesterday for bank stocks, inside day yesterday for the NASDAQ, inside day yesterday for the SOX index. So inside days are days of indecision. The market was watching the S&P 500 closely. The reversal back above 1300 was enough to keep these indexes up. We did see downward pressure in precious metal stocks, of course, with Newmont leading the way lower. We're right on the verge of a new sell signal for the XAU. Now, a lot more trend changes in the Canadian market yesterday as it plays catch-up with the U.S. The TSX Composite Index is now on a daily sell signal. Looks like we've put in a top for the energy sector yesterday, but we're still trading above the upper channel line. Financial services, big up day yesterday, and traded above the upper channel line, but did not close there. So we're still technically on a sell signal, but we need to watch this market closely. Gold stocks are now on a sell signal as of Thursday's close, following material stocks lower and the venture exchange. Moving over, looking at the leveraged ETF trends, again, a lot of changes in the Canadian market relative to the U.S. New sell signal for the TSX bull ETF, but unfortunately not a buy signal for the bear. We're sitting right on the edge. We need a higher close on Friday to give us a buy signal for the bear. For the bear ETF for the financial services, still on a buy signal, even though we had that very volatile day yesterday. And we certainly traded below the lower channel line, but did not close there. So we still need to close below 708.30 to give us a new sell signal for the bear ETF. Looking at the gold, we now have a sell signal for the bull ETF for the gold sector. And a buy signal for the bear ETF for the gold sector. Just a quick note on the U.S. leveraged ETFs. Looks like they're doing roll-ups this week. So if you had five shares of something yesterday, you might have one share today. It doesn't affect us mathematically. Remember, we work in percentages. So if you invested $1,000 in the bear financial ETF, of course, you're still going to be invested $1,000 in that ETF. It does screw up the charts for a couple of days until the data providers fix the historical data. We'll be watching them closely to make sure there's no major trend changes we need to be aware of. And there certainly wasn't yet. Yesterday, as we saw all those inside days. Taking a look at 60-minute charts, starting with the S&P 500, nice setup. We've down at the bottom of the panic zones, there's a pressure zone forming, so we're looking for a move higher here. The low of yesterday was actually a bullish reversal signal. A quick and sharp move down below 1300, came back very quickly, ran up to the upper channel line and stopped there. Looks like we're going to close above 1309.09 at the open on Friday morning, so that should give us an intraday buy signal. We're looking at 1312.50. It looks like we're going to blow through that, and then 1320.31, and that target is right in line with the hourly flypaper channel. So that's where we're expecting to top out today. And of course, on the downside, we'll be watching the 1300 level to see if we can get an hourly close below that. But that's certainly not going to happen at the open on Friday. Last up, we'll take a look at the Canadian market. Similar situation here. We're oversold. We've got a nice pressure zone. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. The flypaper channel is not going to mean that much today because we're basically stuck to it. So it's not going to act as a lot of resistance. So let's watch the 14,000 level on the TSX. We came down. We found support in the open gap yesterday. That's where we made the low. And so we're looking for a move higher from here. An hourly close above 13,983 would give us an intraday buy signal. Now, I have less confidence in the Canadian market moving higher with a downward pressure on commodities today, but it's certainly possible. So that 13,983 level is just below the 14,000 level of resistance. So if we can get above 14,000, then you've got something going on. But otherwise, I think we'll struggle to get up and past that point on Friday. Okay, that's all for Friday morning, folks. So we are looking for a pop at the open. We might not see that pop in the Canadian market as well. Now, over the weekend on Saturday, we're doing a server upgrade. We're going to make some more changes on Saturday, and we'll put a notice on the website if we think we're going to be down for any length of time. Otherwise, I'll do a couple of videos on Sunday, and we'll get caught up with some of the sector videos that I didn't get to this week. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you soon. We'll be right back.